Om Namah Shivaya students, we have been reading the text, The 100 Dresses Part 1. Till now, we have seen Wanda Petronsky was not coming to the school and people didn't even notice that. But on the third day, Peggy and Maddie noticed that she was not coming to the school. And this was because they couldn't make fun out of her. Now let's see what happens next from this video. Wanda Petronsky. Most of the children in room 13 didn't have names like that. They had names easy to say, like Thomas, Smith or Alan. There was one boy named Bounce, Willie Bounce, and people thought that was funny, but not funny in the same way that Petronsky was. Wanda was a Pole who had immigrated to America. Her fellow classmates thought that Wanda Petronsky was a strange name because they had simpler and easier American names. Except a guy named Willie Bounce, which they thought sounded funny, but still lesser than Petronsky. They found her name to be long and unfamiliar. This shows that those children didn't understand diversity and whatever they did was done out of thoughtlessness. Wanda didn't have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang right. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. She didn't have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes, they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the one hard ground. Wanda was usually seen wearing a faded blue dress that did not fit her properly. Though clean, it used to look unironed. This shows that Wanda belonged to a poor family who could not afford too many dresses. Ironically, a lot of people talked to her, but she didn't have any friends because all of them talked to her in order to make fun of her. From her tale about 100 dresses to her unfamiliar name, they found it all amusing. When she used to watch the little girls play in the ground, it was at that time other students surrounded her to mock her. Wanda, Peggy would say in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Wanda, she'd say, giving one of her friends a nudge. Tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? 100, Wanda would say. 100? Exclaimed all the little girls, incredulously. And the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. Yeah, 100, all lined up, said Wanda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. Yeah, all silk, all colors. Velvet too? Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses. Wanda would repeat stolidly. All lined up in my closet. Then they would let her go. And then before she would gone very far, they couldn't help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. With no intentions of hurting her, Peggy used to ask the number of dresses Wanda has in a very polite and respectful tone. They made fun of her because they couldn't understand why she made up that story about 100 dresses. They did all this while being ignorant of the fact that it could hurt her. No one would believe her when she said she possessed 100 dresses, all lined up in her closet. As the other girls screamed in astonishment, the little girls would stop playing in order to see what was going on. Wanda would affirm their queries that she had dresses made of velvet and silk too. Sad Sadly, after she left, they all used to laugh at her. 100 dresses! Obviously, the only dress Wanda had was the blue one she wore every day. So why did she say she had 100 dresses? What a story! How many shoes did you say you had? 60 pairs, all lined up in my closet. Cries of exaggerated politeness greeted this. All alike? Oh no, every pair is different. All colors, all lined up. Peggy, who had thought up this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend, were always the last to leave. Finally, Wanda would move up the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed, hitching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had, finishing the walk to the school alone. It was hard to believe what Wanda said, because the only dress she was seen wearing was the blue one that was faded. No one was sure as to why she lied, although they were teasing her. They were never rude to her. Thus, in the same tone, they continued asking her about the number of shoes she said she had, to which she replied 60, each pair different. It was Peggy's idea to embarrass her like that. Though she was polite, Peggy and Maddie, the inseparable friends, were the last ones to leave the school while Wanda would go back all alone with her dull eyes and behaved in a strange way. So, till here we see that she has been bullied very badly by the other girls, mostly Peggy and Maddie. But the tone was quite polite, to which Wanda would every time reply. The questions that were asked to her were how many dresses she had and how many pairs of shoes she possessed. To which Wanda would always reply she had 100 dresses of all different colors, made of silk and velvet, and 60 pairs of shoes different from each other. Now we'll see in the next video what happens to these replies and what Wanda does. Thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.